it's Katie from The Fabric Scroll, and today I'm going to show you how to make this advent calendar, which comes as a panel. It's one of Stuart Hood's Christmas collection this year, his Nutcracker collection. So it's really simple, and you should have plenty of time to make it for Christmas still. So yeah, I'm going to show you how to do that now. We're going to start by cutting out around the dotted lines. So the top piece here, I'll fold it so you can see. The top piece here is going to be the size of the panel. We're going to cut around those dotted lines first. And then the bottom half are the pockets. But with these, it's just the strips, so make sure you don't cut them out individually. We're just going to do the long strips. Okay, so you could use scissors. But I'm going to use a rotary cutter and a ruler to do this. It's nicely quick that way. So line it up on your dotted line. You are going to need some loops to hang this with. So I think I am going to utilise these bits that I've cut off to make some loops. So we've got a bit less waste. That's the main panel. And then for the pockets. Go long ways first. What I like about this design is that the pockets are in strips, and it means it's a lot less time consuming than some of the others where you've got to cut out and then sew each individual pocket, which is really fiddly. Strips. I've got a couple of stages next. So you need to baste some batting onto the back of this. Now I've got a scrap left over. It's got a bit of a cut in it, but that's all going to be sewn in, so waste not want not. We'll make sure we'll get that used. So what I think I'll do is I'm going to pin it on. And I'm going to do some quilting over the top, and possibly around the Merry Christmas might be nice, and then maybe just some lines in between or on the edge of the pockets, but I'll see how I feel about that as I go. also need to do is, as per the instructions, we need to double press a quarter inch hem at either short end, so that's this end. And then we're going to do a quarter inch hem along the bottom. So you, if, when you're doing your ironing, make sure you do all your stages of your ironing at the same time. So I'm going to do this and this next. Okay, so I've got my panel, it's pinned, I'm just going to baste it now. So I've decided I'm just going to literally go around each strips where the numbers are going to go, just along the edge. I'm just going to do a back stitch. So you can't overly see it at the moment, but it's going to make your calendar stronger. It's going to mean that the layers don't slip around, and I'm just going to repeat that with each row. Okay, so I've done all the basting around the strips, and now I'm going to have a go at free motion stitching over the Merry Christmas. So you can do this any way you want. You could do just free motion in the red or around the edges. So yeah, there's no real rules of this bit, but I am going to give this a go, see if I can add a bit more detail. So I've changed to my darning foot. I'm going to put this a bit closer so you can see. So the trick's to just keep going, basically. Try not to stop. Easier to spell if I'm sewing the right way. That's too bad. Just adds a different dimension to it as well. Let's try next with Christmas. pleased with that. I'm glad I braved that. Okay, so now I've got some ironing to do. So I've got my straps that I've, well, the loops that I'm going to make and the cut-off cuts. I've sewn down the long edge and I've turned them, well, I've turned this one out so I can show you. I'm going to press so the seam is down the centre. Might take some manipulating to get it into place. So that's probably about a good loop size, isn't it? How many can we get out of that? So we can get a 3. I'll probably do both. I think an even number might make more sense. I'm just going to give the panel itself a bit of an iron. The instructions don't actually say to turn the top one over, but I'm definitely going to turn the top over. And you'll need to sew down that. I'd say do that first. I'm going to do all the ironing first though. It says to fold over a double quarter inch seam allowance on each short end. That's what that one is. And then fold, press down the bottom edge as well. So you've pressed down the top edge, bottom edge, and then doubled it over on each short edge. You just need to repeat that with all of them. So this bit isn't actually on the instructions, but is definitely a vital part. We're going to just do a top stitch along the top of all of the pockets, because you don't want that raw edge showing. But also we're going to go and stitch that down now, the ones that we've just pressed. It's also going to help that edge stay down. Side edges we needed to double over, so I've opened up one of them so that that raw edge will now be tucked away. That will be nice and neat, so I'm going to go repeat that with all of them now. So now what we need to do is I've pinned each edge. You need to line up so that they match top and bottom. Just pin them into place.
do that with each number. So you'll see that they look baggy. Don't worry. So we're going to go and sew each line here, first of all. Now I am just going to stick to red because I could keep changing colour, but we'll be here all day. Make sure you do a back stitch at the start end. If you've laid your pins vertical like this, and they're quite, like, my pins are quite thin. I know my sewing machine can handle going over them. It all depends on your sewing machine, whether you sew over your pins, and personal preference. I know loads of people will be shouting at me for doing this, but I've never had any problems. Threads now. These scissors are perfect for that. I love it when it looks neat on the back. Mine never does. Look at that. Right, so now we can take these ones out. And now you need to make your box pleats because you've got your pockets looking a bit too big. So what you do is you pinch them and bring them together so they meet. So you can sort of see where the pattern is anyway on these. Gives you an idea of where they need to go. And it is a bit fiddly, it is going to take a little while. Once you get the hang of it, it's fine. Once they are matched up, just pin them. And repeat with the others. So it should pull this taut then, so you'll be able to sew straight across it. There we go, so they're all neatly pinned. I'm now going to go along the short edge and then the bottom long edge. So that's 5 pockets down and the rest to go. Already looks really exciting. So these style pockets just means you can get a little bit more in. And like I said earlier, it's a lot less fiddly than doing each individual pocket and sewing them all down around each side. When you've done them all, you'll need to give them a press as well, and then they'll look even sharper. Right, so all my pockets are on, and I have basted some loops onto the top. I've got a piece of fabric that's the same size. It's from the same collection, it's one of Stuart's, so this is what I'm going to use to back it with. So I'm going to place it face down. Give it a bit of a shake. Make sure those tabs are on the inside. Once it's all nice and flat, pin all around the edges. This is the final step, so we're getting there now. So far this has taken me about an hour and 45 minutes, so it's taken me about 2 hours, and that's including setting up the videos and stuff. So it's quite a quick one really, for something that's going to last every year. Inch seam allowance, and we need to leave a gap, so I'm going to start halfway down a side, so I've got enough room to leave a gap to turn it out. You basted it, they need to be in the seam, so you want to make sure that the ones that the seam, the stitching already done, doesn't show. Of the gap that I've left. the corners just so they are a bit sharper when we turn out. Make sure you don't cut through the bit you've just sewn though. Okay, make sure all your pins are definitely out so you don't end up spiking yourself. Just found another one. Knitting needle at the ready. I'm just going to use that to poke out the corners. Oops. We've got away with that. All that's left to do is to press it and then top stitch around the edge so it stays nice and neat. And we're finished.